Hello students, how are you all? I hope you're all doing great. Stay home, stay safe. Attitude is altitude. Class 10, English, Unit 1. Revision by David Brainerd K, School Assistant English. Personality development. This unit comprises three readings. A reading, attitude is altitude. Students, let us look into the unit and try to revise what we have studied earlier. Are you ready for the revision? Great. Let us move ahead. Students, let us open our textbooks to Unit 1, Personality Development. And let us read a reading, Attitude is Altitude. Now pause the video for a while and read the lesson, Attitude is Altitude. Can you guess the people here in the pictures? That's great. In the first picture, Sudha Chandran, the great dancer. In the second picture, the great scientist, Stephen Hawking. Of course, in the third picture, the great poetess, the blind poetess, Helen Keller. Now, let's dwell on these two questions for a while. Students, what qualities have made these persons so great? Think and answer. Second question, what qualities do you think a person requires to become successful? Think and respond. Students, shall we recap the lesson, Attitude is Altitude, which we have already studied earlier? Now, let us try to remember important points from this lesson. Imagine having no arms to stretch in the morning, to help you scratch the itch, to allow you to wrap your arms around your loved ones. Imagine having no legs to kick pebbles down the street, to walk or run, to bicycle or skateboard, or get you from point A to point B. Then imagine both at once, which is what Nick Vujicic has faced his whole life. Have you heard something like this before? Nick Vujicic was born with no arms or legs, but he does not let the details stop him. About Nick, the brave 26-year-old, who is mainly torso, plays football and golf, swims and surfs, despite having no limbs. Nick has a small foot on his left hip, which helps him balance and enables him to kick. He uses his one foot to type, write with a pen, and pick things up between his toes. "I call it my chicken drumstick," joked Nick, who was born in Melbourne, Australia, but now lives in Los Angeles. "I'd be lost without it." Children, let's know about Nick's childhood. Nick was an incomplete child to his parents. Nick was born without arms and legs. Nick was a torso. His disability is called phocomelia. Nick was born in Melbourne, Australia, but now lives in Los Angeles. His father was a computer programmer and an accountant. His mother was a nurse. Nick has a small foot on his left hip, which helps him balance. Nick jokes, "I call it my chicken drumstick." Nick uses his small foot to type, to write, to pick things up. Let's recap. Nick can play football, golf, swim, surf. There were many funny incidents happened in the life of Nick. Nick remembers one incident like that. Once I was in a car and a girl at traffic lights was giving me the eye. She could only see my head. So I decided to do a 360 in the car seat to freak her out. Her face was like, "Ooh, what is going on?" She speed off really quickly. Now, let's know how can a torso do all these? With his qualities like positive attitude, perseverance, strong willpower, faith, hope, discipline, and dedication. You know how can a torso do all these? It will even happen with his parents' support. His parents did their best to make him independent. Nick's dad put him in the water at 18 months to make him learn swimming. Nick's mother invented a plastic device to hold a pen or pencil. You know, his parents joined him in the mainstream school. Yes, he was teased and bullied in the school, but finally, he acquired a degree in financial planning and real estate. Wow. Anyone with some problems, aggravated problems, difficulties, they'll go into depression. Even it happened to Nick. About Nick's depression. Nick was deeply depressed when he was only 80 years old. 8 years old. He went to his mom crying and told her that he wanted to kill himself. Remember, at age 10, Nick tried to drown himself in the bath. At 13 years, he read a newspaper article about a disabled man. Then he realized why God has made him like that, to give hope to others. Nick says, "I wanted to concentrate on something good that I had." After that, Nick chose Bethany Hamilton as a surfing master who had her arm bitten off by a shark and quickly learned how to do the 360 degree spin on his skateboard. Now let's know about his success. The success story has got a great start and there are many people who are motivated by him. Nick has become a motivational speaker and has visited different countries, inspiring the people over there. He got married to Kanye in 2012 and is blessed with a healthy baby boy. Shall we look into some of the quotes by Nick? He says, "If you can't get a miracle, become one." This means, if you don't get any miracle from somewhere, if you don't see any wonders around, you become a wonder. You become a miracle. Great, isn't it? Another quote of him is, "If I fail, I try again and again and again." If you fail, are you going to try again? The human spirit can handle much worse than we realize. It matters how you are going to finish. Are you going to finish strong? This is a great quote by Nick, because there are so many people who try, they fail and they stop. But are they trying again? Fail and again and again. So don't stop until you reach your goal. There is another quote. "If I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done." Really great quote, right? He just says, if I can encourage one person, if I can change one person, if I can stop somebody who is committing suicide, I think that's the greatest victory. So that's why he says, if I can encourage just one person, then my life is really a successful one. That's what he says. And his job is finished. Now let us have a self-check on this lesson, attitude is altitude. There are four questions here. Let's try to answer. I call it my chicken drumstick, joked Nick. What is it? How does it help him? It refers to the small foot on his left hip. It helps him balance and enables him to kick a ball. He used it to type, to write, to pick things, to balance himself. So he talks about the small leg. It's not actually leg or foot, but it's a small projection that he himself jokes on it, saying that it is a drumstick, as if like drum, you know, that he can beat. So you can write this answer for that. Or simply you can write like, it refers to small foot on his left hip. That is done, right? And how does it help? He can kick, he can type, he can write, and he can pick things. And he can even balance with that. Yes, he doesn't have hands, no? So he doesn't have arms. So he has no legs even. So to balance, I think that small foot, you know, that helps him. Second question. How did Nick's parents help him to become independent? Both the parents really worked hard. I think we have discussed just now. So Nick's parents helped him a lot. They wanted him to be independent. They did not send him to special school. They kept at home. Father put him in water when he was just 18 months old. He taught him how to swim. And then he taught him how to type also. And you know, his mother has made a special plastic tool to hold a pen or pencil or some other utensils. So that is how they have helped. They have spared their time. Parents were there at home for him and they started working for him. They helped him a lot. Third question. What made Nick choose Bethany Hamilton to learn surfing? The qualities of Bethany Hamilton, such as courage, determination, faith, that made him choose her. He learned surfing in just 48 hours. Because she is also a person who has lost her arms. But she has got a lot of courage. That's why he has chosen her as a teacher for surfing. Fourth question. What do you learn from the life of Nick Ujicic? We can learn so many lessons. We have just noted down three or four life lessons. One should not lose hope, right? Number two, you should have qualities of determination. And his life is a source of inspiration. So that story itself, his story really inspires many. Students, now let us look into B reading. Every success story is also a story of great failures. We have already learned certain things from this lesson. Now, let us recap what all we have studied. So students, pause the video for a while and read the lesson. Every success story is also a story of great failures. Hope you'll enjoy reading it once. You have read the lesson, right? The lesson started with a quotation by Tom Watson, sir. If you want to succeed, double your failure rate. Okay? If you want to have a success, you should double your failure rate. That means there should be more failures. That means you are learning a lot. One day you will succeed. So below are some of the examples of failures of successful people. From the lesson, I have noted down a few of the names and a simple explanation for those people. First, Abraham Lincoln. He was elected president of the United States at the age of 52, having been failed number of times, right? The next one is Lee De Forest. He is the inventor of triodes tube. He was actually once publicly humiliated. You have also read from the lesson about the Wright brothers, who have invented a machine. It's heavier than air that would fly. And you know about Colonel Sanders from the lesson, that they have sold their mother's recipe, the food that they have prepared, out of her their mother's recipe, they have succeeded. Walt Disney. Disney is one of the wonderful characters you see. They have created a number of great characters. See, Walt Disney, after seeing a small mouse, he was inspired. And then he started off Mickey Mouse. Next comes Thomas Edison. Failed approximately 10,000 times, it seems, while he was working on the light bulb. Next is Henry Ford. He broke at the age of 40. First, there was no reverse gear for this, right? Lee LaCocqua was fired by Henry Ford too at the age of 54. Beethoven, I think I should not mention him because he is a great legend. You need not need any explanation that he was told that he had no talent for music, but he gave some of the best music to the world. Beethoven's music, we call it, right? So many great people had number of failures. So these people are listed in our lesson. So some of them are very, very important because for the cause of exam also, we need to remember those people's failure stories. So the great conclusion for this lesson is a young man coming and asking Socrates the secret to success. So when a young man asked Socrates the secret to success, Socrates told the young man to meet him near the river the next morning. So they met. Socrates asked the young man to walk with him towards the river. When the water got up to their neck, Socrates took the young man by surprise and ducked him in the water. The boy struggled to get out of, but Socrates was strong and kept him there until the boy stared, turning blue. Socrates pulled his head out of the water, and the first thing the young man did was to gasp and take a deep breath of air. Socrates asked, What did you want the most when you were there? He asked, what did this young man wanted when he was under the waters? The boy replied, air. Air. Socrates said, that is the secret to success. When you want success as badly as you wanted the air, then you'll get it. There is no other secret. So, to conclude the lesson, a burning desire is the starting point of all accomplishment. Just like a small fire cannot give much heat, a weak desire cannot produce great results. So, it's self-check time. There are two questions here. The first one, to Lincoln, defeat was a detour and not a dead end. Justify this statement from the life of Lincoln. If this is a question, the answer should be like this. Every success story has a failure behind it. Lincoln's life is an excellent example. He failed many times before he became president of USA at the age of 52. He failed in business at the age of 21 and 24 years. He proved that winners never quit and quitters never win. Thus, he proves that defeat was a detour and not a dead end. Detour means a roundabout route. So defeats may sometimes, you know, delay the success. Defeats, failures may delay the success, but it will never stop the success. So it's detour means it's a long roundabout route. So we may arrive late. We may come to the success winning stand late, but it will definitely happen. So a failure is a detour and not a dead end. So that's not the full stop. So second question, what did Socrates suggest as a secret to success? Socrates is a world philosopher, right? So he suggested that one strong desire is a secret to success. A young man comes there and he asks the secret to success. Then he will ask him to come to the river next day. And we remember the story, right? He will take him to the neck deep waters and he will try to put the young man's head into the water. And he will never He will not allow the young man to lift his head. The young man will be turning blue. Then he will allow him to come out of water. And the first thing that the young man does is gasp for air, take a deep breath. So Socrates asks him, what was you looking for when you were in water? What were you strongly desiring for? He said, air, nothing more than that. So when you wanted that air, when you had that strong desire, you have actually won. Similarly, if you have burning desire, then that is a root success. Small fire cannot give much heat, but a strong fire above can give light, right? So this is a wonderful question and answer page here. You can work on other stories as well. Practice, practice, practice. That will make you perfect. Here is a chart that has three columns. One column is on a person, the second column about his failures or rejections he faced, and then the final success in the last column. So we have almost like 9 people here. Let's start with Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln had many failures. Failure in business, defeated in legislative elections. He had nervous breakdown. He lost congressional race and senatorial race. So everywhere he failed. But final success, he was elected as President of United States of America. The second one is Lee De Forest. He is the one who has been charged by the district attorney. He was humiliated. But later he was appreciated. He was given with a lot of accolades, praises, because he has invented the triodes tube. The third one, Wright Brothers, we'll never forget. A New York Times editorial questioned the wisdom of the Wright Brothers. Are they the right people? So someone was questioning him, the New York Times. Final success is, he took their famous flight at Kitty Hawk. So they flew one day, and that made the beginning of aeroplane. So they had success. The fourth one, Colonel Sanders, he knocked many doors before he got the first order. He asked so many people, come on, purchase my food. I have prepared something new, my mother's recipe. But no one has opened the door. But he became famous as a businessman. And his restaurant, you know, he founded was Kentucky Fried Chicken, KFC. It has got chain restaurants. There are many restaurants. Today we have KFCs in India too. And you got the next list. That is about a few more people. Walt Disney. Newspaper editors rejected him. They said, you know, he had no talent. So all his stories, nothing. Nobody has taken him. But final success, he created some of the world's most well-known fictional characters, including Mickey Mouse. He was well-known as animator, film producer, director, screenwriter, voice actor, entrepreneur, entertainer, international icon, and philanthropist. See, such a great man he is. Thomas Edison is the sixth person here. As a child, he was considered to be a stupid. Lost his factory to fire. But finally, when he grew up, he became a great scientist. Henry Ford, he has forgotten to put the reverse gear in his first car. He broke at the age of 40. But finally, he established a cars company. Eighth one, Lee Lakauko. Lee, fired by Henry Ford II. He's well known for engineering the Ford Mustang and the Ford Pinto cars and became one of the most famous business people in the world. And we have one more person, and Beethoven. Beethoven is actually said initially that he had no talent for music. But finally he gave some of the best music to the world. Beethoven's music. So this is a wonderful sheet where there is failures in one column and success in the other column. I think this will help you a lot. We have come to the serious part of our discussion. That is practice time. In the light of our question paper for this academic year, let us analyze the question paper in brief and let's look into the reading comprehension passages. Question paper has three parts in it: Section A, Section B, and Section C. Section A is all about reading comprehension passages. There are four variety of passages taken from reading A and reading B and from study skills. Section B is all about vocabulary questions and grammar questions. C is all about study skills. So there may be a map, there may be a table, there may be a pie diagram, there may be a graph that will be given, and the data from that should be analyzed and the questions are to be answered. So let us now discuss Section A, that is reading comprehension passages. There are four variety of passages, as I have already told. The first five questions are from the first reading comprehension passage taken from A reading. From the passage, there will be five questions, two WH questions, which means those questions that starts with WH words, like which, why, what, where, how, whom, why, and so on. And there may be three multiple choice questions. The answers will be given there. The student has to select the right option. 6 to 8 questions. Three questions are taken from a poem. All are multiple choice questions. And this is B reading. And then you have 9 to 10 questions from B reading again, from the prose sections. There will be two multiple choice questions. Both are to be answered. 11th question to 15th question, they are from study skills, as I've already told you. The question paper setter may give you a pie chart, a bar chart, a tabular format, from where you need to retrieve the information, analyze it, and you have to answer the questions. There'll be two WH questions and three multiple choice questions in it. Totally 15 questions, each carries 2 marks, so total marks would be 30. So it is very easy to secure 30 marks here. So practice is very essential. Practice, practice, practice. Let us see the first passage from A reading. It is just for the model's sake. The first questions are from this passage. The passage is before you. Let's have a look at it. I'm going to read for you. It is from Attitude is Altitude, the lesson that we have just read now. Nick Vujicic was born with no arms and legs, but he doesn't let the details stop him. The brave 26-year-old, who is mainly a torso, plays football and golf, swims and surfs, despite having no limbs. Nick has a small foot on his left hip, which helps him balance and enables him to kick. He uses his foot to type, to write with a pen and pick things up between his toes. I call it my chicken drumstick, joked Nick, who was born in Melbourne, Australia, but now lives in Los Angeles. I'd be lost without it. And try to answer the following questions. Where was Nick born? We already have that answer from the passage towards the end of it. He was born in Australia in a place called Melbourne, but he now doesn't live there. He lives in Los Angeles, USA. Second question, how does his small foot help Nick? We have already seen it in the middle of the passage, that the small foot, which he considers to be the chicken drumstick, he uses it to balance, he uses it to pick up certain things, he uses that one even to kick the football. So there are so many works that he does with that small foot that he has. So you can write any points of these, because it is for 2 marks, you can write. So the first two questions are WH type. WH questions are those questions which start with WH words, like what, which, where, why, how, and so on. Here we see WH question, WHERE, where, talks about place. How is another question, which talks about the manner of action. Third question and fourth question, fifth question, all these three questions are multiple choice. So we get the answer. We have the answer here, one among those options given. Question number three, but he doesn't let the details stop him. What does this sentence mean? From the story, we have understood that there are so many problems that this Nick has. He doesn't have arms, he doesn't have legs, and he is not cared by anyone. But still, those did not stop him. So he still became a famous personality. So option A is, his disability stops his achievements. Is it stopping? No. His disability does not stop his achievements. So there is a contrast here. So one of these two should be the answer. Always it is like that. You'll get a very good choice where you need to think of. There'll be confusion. C, I think this can be eliminated. He always thinks of his disability. No, he doesn't think always about his disability. Initially he was thinking, but later he has left that kind of thinking. So answer should be from A or B. So his achievements are not stopped. So disability cannot stop his achievements. So answer should be B. Fourth question. I call it my chicken drumstick, joked Nick. It refers to what? We have already referred it in the question number one, question number two, sorry. So that is chicken drumstick means arms and legs. Chicken, it's not A, it's not B, it should be C. Small foot on his left hip. The last question, fifth one. Nick now lives in, so it's again a question, extension to the first question. Where was Nick born and now where is he? So for both the questions, you get the answer from the last line. So Los Angeles is the answer. So this is how you have to answer. So it's very easy, isn't it? It's very easy to answer this set of questions. So 10 out of 10 you can expect from this area. Let us see, not the very next passage that is of poem, but we will see the third passage that is from B reading. And that B reading, you can find one passage with two questions. Here in this passage, we find very small lines here given. So it is from Every Success Story is also a story of great failures. We have just read. So there are two small paragraphs here. This man was Abraham Lincoln. Would you call him a failure? He could have quit. But to Lincoln, defeat was a detour, not a dead end. In 1913, Lee D. Forrest, inventor of the triodes tube, was charged by the district attorney for using fraudulent means to mislead the public into buying stocks of his company. So this is yet another passage which is very simple but may or may not have all the answers within it. So the first question here, so the number is changed here because we have skipped one set of three questions from the poem. So we did not look into poem. So those are 6, 7, 8 questions. So tomorrow or next sessions we will look into that. So 9th and 10th questions here. Do you call Abraham Lincoln a failure? Why? So the answers are already given there. Yes, because he became old. No, because he did not quit. He proved that winners never quit and quitters never win. So answer is B. So yes, he failed many times is not an answer here at all. So 10th question, what is the invention of Lee D. Forrest? He did not invent computer. It is Charles Babbage who has invented the computer. Aeroplane, we know the Wright brothers. It is triodes tube. So it will be always easy to answer questions because the questions will have answers from the passage. Let us discuss the last passage that is about a table given here. So it is a study skills. There may be a table, sometimes there may be pie chart also. There may be a graph, a bar chart, or it can be even a graph type. So now today let us see this table given there. It's very simple table given. The key is already down there. So let's dwell on the questions now. Read the following table regarding the fire accidents in the textile factory in a country. So again, here are 5 questions given. And there is a table to the left and the questions on the right. Normally the questions will be down there for the want of space. We have, for the convenience sake, we have put the questions just beside the table. So this is about fire accidents in a textile factory in a country. No country is mentioned here, so the name is not necessary probably. And now there is a cause: short circuiting, smoking, scrap burning, unknown reasons. Total cases there. In the year 2011, 2012, 2013, they are given horizontally. So short circuiting in 2011 is 98. Through, because of short circuiting, the number of fire accidents that took place in 2012 are 74, in 2013 64 respectively. So because of smoking, somebody throws a half lit cigarette, and because of that, fire accidents took place in 2011 almost 50, in 2012 45, in 2013 it increased to 65. So in that way we need to look into the table. And the damage in piece also is given. 2011 it is 2,96,000. That is the loss that they have got. So this is how we need to just look into the matter here. The questions will be there. So it is just, you know, getting the data from the given table. What information is given in the table? So such kind of questions, you know, two questions will be there, WH questions. These two questions, you know, will be normally getting answers from the passage titles. So what information is given in the table? We'll get it from the title. The title is regarding the fire accidents in textile factories in a country during the years 2011 to 13. That's the answer. B. Which factory is responsible for the increase of accidents in 2013? Factors. Reason. What is the reason for increase of accidents, fire accidents in 2013? So let us look into 2013 column. Then when you look there, you know, 64, 65, 27, 04, that's the total number, 160. So 65, so that means smoking. Because of smoking in 2013, fire accidents took place more. So smoking, it is already given in the options there, smoking number one. When were the fire accidents more in the textile factories? Is it in 2013 or is it in 2012 or is it in 2011? So fire accidents more in textile factories. So total you can take, total 182 in 2011, 163, 160. So almost 2011, it's more. So option C is the answer, or 3 is the answer. Right? So 2011 is the answer. When were the fire accidents more in textile factories? So the answer is 2011. And then the last question, choose the correct statement basing the information provided in the table. Which is the correct statement? Smoking is the main cause for the fire accidents in the textile factory. Is it smoking alone is the main cause? The fire accidents have been decreasing year by year. Fire accidents, are they decreasing year by year? Yeah, 182 in 2011, 163 in 2012, 213 in 2013, there are only 160. So they, year by year, they are decreasing. That is true statement. So a lot of damage happened in 2013 of all the years. 2013, lot of damage? No, not at all. That's wrong statement. So option 2 is the right answer. So there'll be 2 open-ended questions and 3 multiple choice questions. So isn't it easy to answer such kind of passages? Yes, true. It's very, very easy to answer these questions, and it's very easy to get the complete marks. We have 15 questions, 2 marks each, 30 marks you can fetch. Great. So practice, practice, practice. You'll definitely win. So practice more.